house might now fall under the 50-50 rule, meaning tens of thousands of people might need to cough up even more money for repairs on those homes.
The 50-50 rule works like this. Let's say your home was worth $500,000. If damage from Hurricane Ian goes over $250,000, or half your home's value, you have to bring your home up to new flood codes, which can be pricey. If it's less than 50%, you don't.
Here's the issue, though. FEMA says your property value was overinflated last year, which could change how the 50-50 rule could affect you. ABC 7's Joshua Cole is getting us more tonight on how the officials are responding to those changes.
FEMA told Lee County and Fort Myers Beach officials there was a wide disparity in property values after Ian. Those leaders are saying while they get this worked out, they're telling you it'll cost you, but you may need to get a private appraisal done.
I mean, we lost everything in the house. Yeah. It was just gone. We gutted everything. Everything's in 2x4s now.
Again, we're doing everything as much as we can ourselves on the cheap.
Pete and John are just two of the hundreds on Fort Myers Beach and nearly 100,000 others in Lee County rebuilding.
Give me a solid target. You know, just give me a number and let me know what I'm shooting for.
After more than 4 months, FEMA is saying your home's value must come from pre-Ian records, not the tax roll value letter the Lee County property appraiser and the county said to use.
So that's where we're really totally befuddled by this letter. It's one of the approved methods in the FEMA handbook, and what we've used in our tax value letter is exactly the same methodology that any appraiser would use.
In this letter addressed to Fort Myers Beach previous mayor, FEMA says without knowing how these adjustments are being calculated, we cannot determine if these values are acceptable.
You hate to think it, but it is so out of left field, it almost feels political at some level.
Meanwhile, county officials say they're talking with FEMA to figure out the appropriate just value calculation, whether it's from the property appraiser or another calculation. No office has said how this affects permits already approved.
Does this grow the number? Does it shrink the number?
That number we don't know. We don't know how it affects people who have already got the permit.
The decision by FEMA is leaving leaders like Fort Myers Beach Mayor Dan Allers with more questions, because ultimately FEMA helps decide if we keep our flood insurance.
You know, for the betterment of our residents, we have to follow the guidance that we're given to be able to stay in the National Flood Insurance Program. The best course of action is to go out and get a private appraisal.
A FEMA representative just responded to our request for comment, saying residents should still continue to work with their local floodplain administrator and contact the local building code department for any questions you might have about permits. We also know that Fort Myers Beach Mayor Allers is meeting with FEMA representatives tomorrow to find out more about these changes and what they mean for you. We're in downtown Fort Myers in front of the Lee County Administrator Building. I'm Joshua Cole, ABC 7.
The only public boat launch.